अनुसंधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे आई एम टू डिलीवर माय लेक्चर ऑन द पोयम डेथ बी नॉट प्राउड रिटन बाय अ वेल नोन मेटाफिजिकल पोएट जॉन डन। At the very initial stage, I would like to introduce myself. Myself is Mrs. Poonam Valera from Jamnagar. I have been performing my duty as a lecturer in English department at Akadoshi Mahila College. Now, first of all, I would let you know somewhat about John Donne. Actually, John Donne started his early career whenever we find him as a passionate lover and rebel of sense. But later John Donne was somewhat different. Later John Donne shifted his, journey and conceived his journey for the search of truth. And then we can find a number of metaphysical aspects in his every kind of poetry. Now today we would like to share more and more about Death Be Not Proud. This is a brief background for John Donne. John Donne was born in 1572 in London, England. He is known as the founder of the metaphysical poets, a term created by Samuel John Johnson. The loosely associated group also includes George Herbert, Richard Crashew, Andrew Marvell, and John Calvin. All these are called metaphysical poets. The metaphysical poets are known for their ability to startle the reader and coax new perspective. Actually, here I want to define that what is metaphysical poetry. So actually it is a name, title for a particular concept. And that concept is used by metaphysical poets through paradoxical images, subtle argument, inventive syntax and imagery from art, philosophy and religion. All these features will be appropriately applicable to our poetry, Death Be Not Proud. Don't reach beyond the rational and hierarchical structures of the 17th century. To do this, Don has done exacting the ingenious consents, advancing an exploratory spirit of his time. Both these features are quite remarkable in every kind of poetry of John Donne. Now, I would like to share something and I would like to share about introductory part that Death Be Not Proud presents an argument against the power of death. Here our poet John Donne has addressed death, but one of the most remarkable and striking element is that Donne has addressed death as a person. It means we can find the application and usage of personification here. And personification is also one of the concepts which was used a number of metaphysical poets who were contemporary of John Donne also. So far this poem is concerned, here John Donne addressing death as a person. The speaker wants death against pride in his power. Finally, the speaker predicts the end of death itself, stating, "Death, thou shalt die." Actually, this is the layout for the whole poem. Now, I would like to analyze all the poem by quatrain. The first quatrain focuses on the subject and audience of the poem. And the major aspect which is revealed in this poem is about death. The second quatrain, which is closely linked to the first, turns the criticism of death as less than fearful into praise for death's good qualities. This is only to give a hint and glimpse to all the students of literature, because whenever we will start to evaluate this poem, they will get a enough idea about the whole structure of the poem. The final couplet caps the argument against death. not only is death the servant of other powers and essentially impotent on truly kill anyone, but also death is itself desire to die. Here I want to share that John Donne is having or is endowed with a very different, calm and sophisticated knowledge about death. Here I would like to share that Dylan Thomas has also written a number of poems regarding death. Other poets have also worked upon death, but John Donne is somewhat different. Dylan Thomas is always praising death, is always showing us the dominant power of death. But John Donne has challenged death. Now about first quatrain. Actually in this poem, poet has invoked death. So it will recited like this also. Death, be not proud. Thou somehow called thee mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so, for those whom thou thinkst thou dost overthrow. Die not, poor death, not yet canst thou kill me. Now again we will start from our first line. Death, be not proud, thou somehow called thee. Here our poet John Donne is challenging the death. Our poet's main reason to challenge death is that actually death is not so powerful as we are thinking it to be. Majority of the people, actually it is in the psychology of all the human beings that death is scary, very and very scary, but actually it is not so. Because Donne has never considered death as to be mighty and dreadful. So this first quatrain reveals about John Donne's different idea about death. For those whom thou thinkst thou dost overthrow, die not, poor death, nor yet canst thou kill me. Here we can find the open challenge by John Donne to this feature, scary death, because John Donne is not considered death as very scary one. But death is not scary, it is not very magnificent, but it is somewhat different in John Donne's opinion. Now we will just discuss about second quatrain. I would like to recite in this way. From rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure than from thee, much more must flow, and soonest our best men with thee do go, rest of their wants and souls delivery. Here the first line, from rest and sleep, which but by pictures be. Here John Donne is comparing death as one of the sleep, a very, very long and peaceful sleep. Whenever any person gets from the sleep, he or she finds herself or himself to be very joyous, to be very energetic. In the same way, John Donne is saying that death is nothing one. It is one of the sleep given us or provided us by God. Because God is having some vision or God is having some target to leave from this world and to enter us into the another territory. Here I would also remember some Gujarati poets also. Sometimes what happened, all the students used to quote some remarks whenever they are writing down any composition in Gujarati or Hindi language. Every time they quote somewhat in English language. But I am surprised to see all this, because if we are delivering any poetry in English, writing down any composition in English, then why should not quote from another language also. So in this reference I would like to remember Rauji Patel's one of the poetry regarding death also. So I would like to intermingle with this in this reference. Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and disparate men, and dost with poison, war, and sickness dwell. Here the poet says, or we can say that here poet has argued that if death is not powerful, or if death is really scary, then God has not invented it for ourselves. It is not only ordinary human beings which can die or which die. Actually, kings also, other men also, great personalities also have also found death. But in the case of death, we have to always remember that due to death, only our body dies, our soul gets eternity. In this sense, I would like to say that death is an inevitable process. That's why, no doubt, all of we know that Mahatma Gandhiji has died, but still he is living in everybody's psychology, in everybody's heart. The same thing is also there. Now, I am to recite the final couplet. And poppy o charms can make us sleep as well, and better than this rock, why swellest thou then? One short sleep past, we wake eternally, and death shall be no more. Death thou shalt die. This is the major and prominent idea expressed by John Donne in this final couplet. The poet wants to say that poppy or charms can make us sleep also. It means if we are feeling any attachment with anything, it may be person, it may be any other subjects, it may be anything, then and then also we feel somewhat scary about death. So death is also like that. Because whenever we have started to live till these long years, we are feeling very attached with ourselves also. We are also attached with all other relatives also. That's why whenever unpredicted death will be there, so every people is finding that it is really scary, but it is not. And that's why I would like to again remember what Rawji Patel has written. And I would also like to recite it in this sense also. Mari aankhe kankuna suraj aathmya, mari vel sanigara vira, jagne sankoro ajvara parine uba. स्वास मारी आंखें कंकुना सूरज आत्म्या. Here this Gujarati poet has told death somewhat eternal, because after that death there will start another life. It will also infuse us with divine energy. It will also lead us to a tremendous joy, to a tremendous goal, which we have to enrich, and then this also will enrich the field of our life journey with number of good deeds also. Now, I would like to discuss what's the theme in it. Donne's theme tells the reader that death has no right to be proud, since human beings do not die but live eternally after one short sleep. This poem's popularity lies in its message of hope, cut in eloquent and quotable language. I have written like this, that John Donne has stated the subject matter or the main theme of the poem in a very eloquent and quotable language. And it's quite natural for John Donne, because he is a metaphysical poet. And metaphysical poet always uses some particular concepts to reveal their main subject matter. So whenever we are to evaluate John Donne's poem at that time, I would like to share that it's not quite easy. It is not everybody's cup of tea. So the proper manner to understand John Donne's metaphysical poetry is that we have to go through all the processes of thought. It means, first of all, we have to think, then we have to ponder, then we have to dwell, then we have to concentrate, then we have to consider, then contemplate, and then meditate. Then and then also it will be possible for us to get the overall glimpse of John Donne's animetaphysical poetry. And the same is also applicable in this very poem, Death, Be Not Proud. And the main thing, whatever the message is hidden here, to convey this message, don't rely primarily on personification, because this personification is one kind of extended metaphor used by John Donne in the form of concept. So this is everything about John Donne's Death, Be Not Proud. That is, death is not scary. And to prove this, to justify this, John Donne has also revealed two or three reasons in this poem. So I would like to analyze this poem, taking into account all these different features, which will justify that death is really not scary. Now, if we concentrate on the very second line of the poem, that mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so. So here we can say that Donne begins the poem by telling death that death has no reason to be proud, because it is so scary, because it is not. He will spend the rest of the poem explaining why death isn't scary. So this is, we can say that the main content of the poem, because it is the initial stage through which the reader can get the idea that in other part of the poem, the poet John Donne is going to reveal some reasons regarding death being not scary in true sense. Now, I would like to discuss the very first reason in this matter. For this, I would like to share that from rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure than from thee, much from must flow. Here, there is another reason quite visible here. Death isn't scary, is that? Death is considered as a long or peaceful sleep by John Donne, and death is just like a better sleep. So death must be even better than sleep. This gives us some hint that whenever we get a proper sleep, it will directly make a very beneficial effect on our mindset and on our body also. It means we will get somewhat released after getting a long and very peaceful sleep. Similarly, John Donne says that our lifespan, or the journey of life, or in searching of the truth, or our life regarding every kind of attributes and the combination of attitude, aptitude, etc. is one kind of journey. And we have been passing from this journey for a number of years. Sometimes we also don't know what will have to be achieved by us. So that kind of journey may get us somewhat nervous also, or make us somewhat tired also. So to relieve us from all this kind of noises, the God has invented this very good mechanism that is called sleep. And there is also another reason why death isn't scary. Here I would like to say, or I would like to argue, that if death is really scary, or if it is not meaningful, then it would not have invented by God, because we can say that God has created everything, taking into account every logic is also there, because death is one kind of regulating device for our whole human being's journey. Actually, it is quite visible in the very line, "And soon as, O best man, with thee go, rest of the bones and soul's delivery." Here it can be said that all the awesome people die, so death must be great. Also, it brings rest and takes your soul to heaven. Here the word "awesome people die" is very meaningful to understand in this regard. Suppose if death is real scary, if death is not so important, then all other personalities, or we can say that great personalities, should not get death according to the norm of the God and etc. But we can say that every great personalities like Mahatma Gandhiji, like others religious figures also, all have got death, but still today they all live in our heart due to their prior and pristine and pure deeds. So it is quite natural for us to understand that if those great personalities can be victim of the death, then it is quite natural for every common man to get death. So we should understand it as a part of God's monetary system, God's one particular mechanism, and we have to follow it also. And now the line, "Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings and desperate men, and thus will poison, war and sickness dwell." So this line is ended with a prominent idea hidden in this also. It means whenever we are to speak this word "slave to fate, chance, kings," at that time we have to take into account some connotative aspects of it. Whenever we find or we refer in dictionary that what's the chance, what's the meaning of kings, desperate men, etc., so they will provide us, or the dictionary will provide us with particular meaning. But John Donne is metaphysical poem, and being metaphysical poet, he has used some connotative aspects to reveal the hidden agenda regarding all this. In this regard, I would like to say that death can't be scary when it can't even control when people die, because kings send people into war and some people commit suicide. This is a very good kind of example. As we know, or if we refer any history and etc., we can see that the king orders his army to go for a fight, to go for a war. He is also aware about the fact that in war anything may be happened. The persons, or we can say the army, may get death, may become the victim of injury and etc. But the king doesn't care about all this. In the same manner, some people get death or in the process of any accident or any without any precautions and etc. So actually this is very sad pattern created by God. If all the human beings are live on the earth, if they will live on the earth, so what we will consider about another population and another human beings? So this is actually God's truest kind of mechanism to control the population on the earth also, to give all the human beings a next chance for indulging into a next life. Some people can't fulfill their old dreams in this very life. So sometimes in their mindset they are thinking that I will do this in my next life, I will do this later on, I will complete or I will achieve my goal later on, everything. So this kind of zest for desires are longing more and more. So death is one kind of pause created by the God. Actually, this pause is provided us by God just to make infused with a more and more vibrant and more vigorous energy also. Now, the very important words are there, and poppy or charms can make us sleep as well, and better than thy store, why swellest thou then? Here it can be said that death hangs out with some bad company. So how powerful could it be? Actually, this is a very good kind of argument done by John Donne in the matter of God to Viscari. Here Donne wants to reveal the fact that death is dealt with, or death is indulging with, a different kind of bitter devices or some evils, namely poison, woe, sickness, dwell, etc. So if in our real world any person is dealing with this kind of evils, then we are saying that this is not a good fellow, this is not a good chap. In the same manner, if death is dealt with this kind of poison, war and sickness, so how we can say that it is quite good, or why it is more powerful? So this is one of the backdrop for the death also. And here is also one of the thing is that death can't be scary when it can even control. And if death cannot control our livelihood, then we should not feel very fearful about death. As for example, it is also said in Bhagavad Gita and etc. that death is inevitable process. And sometimes what happens, people get scarred with the things which will come to them directly, which will come to them without any precautions. But actually it is set pattern of God, and it is quite clear that no man will live more and more and will live eternally. So death is inevitable, he or she will have to meet the death. So if we know this very fact, then why should we get fearful about death? And this is also very provoking line for Donne. And better than thy stroke, why swellest thou, man? One short sleep fast, we wake eternally. It means when we die, we will sleep for a second, and then we will wake up forever. The only thing that will never really die is death itself. So in that way, it is the weaker thing of all. Or we can say that it is the weakest thing on the part of very death. It means Donne is arguing that whenever death confronts us, or whenever death confronts from us, at that time our body gets death only. Our soul is eternal. Our soul starts another journey. And in that another journey, we can say that our soul will search for a better truth, search for more and more energetic life. So this is what Donne has proved. And at last I would like to say that Donne has justified the topic death in a very different manner, following every aspect of metaphysical poetry. Thank you.
अनुसंधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।